differentiating between PCOS and other endocrine disorders, it really has to be a thorough evaluation, because irregular periods could be many reasons. I mean, medications they're on, thyroid problems, genetics, I mean, prolactin. I mean, you can have numerous things that could be wrong. So we really have to, after the first visit of talking, then do an ultrasound. We then do lab work. I have them come back and we sit down and go over everything and look at, okay, what is this telling us? And what part is, oh, look, yes, it looks a little PCOS, but wow, your thyroid is way off. That I think, you know, really your irregular periods are going to be your thyroid. And that can cause you not ovulate, and that can cause some of these other symptoms. But it's just through, I think, a very detailed history and workup.
To differentiate PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome from other disorders, falls on the shoulders of the provider to be thorough enough with their evaluation. And a lot of times it's not the box that you're trying to check. It's a lot of the boxes that you're checking off and what you have left. And so PCOS falls into that category a lot of times. So if I can say that a patient is not menstruating regularly for another reason, then it may be more likely that it's a insulin resistance or PCOS problem. And so it's again, ruling out other things is sometimes what leads you down the road to diagnose PCOS more than anything else.